this video, I'd like to cover a different picture for the singular value decomposition. This is called the diagonalization picture. Suppose you have a matrix A such that Y is equal to AX, or AX is equal to Y, and you know Y, you know A, and you want to solve this system of linear equations. You want to find the vector X such that AX is equal to Y. Now, you know that A can be decomposed into U sigma V transposed multiplied by X is equal to Y. Now, you can multiply by the inverse of U from both sides to have sigma V transposed multiplied by X is equal to U transposed multiplied by Y. Now, you can do some change of variables. Let V transpose X be equal to B and U transpose Y be equal to Z. This means that sigma multiplied by B is equal to Z. And you know Z since you know Y and you know U. You don't know B since you don't know X, but you can write this as follows. You have some diagonal matrix, let's say sigma 1, sigma 2, up to sigma n multiplied by some unknown vector b, b1, b2, up to bn, and this is equal to some known vector z, z1, z2, up to zn. So we have transformed our system of linear equations into a system involving a diagonal matrix. And actually the solution of this is very, very straightforward. You know that sigma n bn is equal to Zn. So you see that Bn is equal to Zn over sigma n. And in general, Bi is equal to Zi over sigma I. So if you transform your system into this diagonal form, the solution becomes very straightforward. And that's why this is called the diagonalization picture of the singular value decomposition. Now, just as I said while I was talking about the diagonalization picture of the eigendecomposition, you generally don't perform SVD if you want to solve the system of linear equations just like that, because calculating the SVD itself is time-consuming and not efficient, and you can solve the system AX equals B using Gaussian elimination much faster. Here I am just telling you why it can be called the SVD diagonalization. If we look more deeply at what we have done here, we have performed some change of variables such that after the transformation, the relation between the variables becomes diagonal. So we have this form again. We have our circle and we also have our ellipse right here. Initially, this is the X space. So here we have, let's say, X1 and X2. Here we have the Y space, so we have Y1 and Y2, just like that. And what the SVD diagonalization picture tells us is the following. We first rotate our vector X until X1 comes here, X1 dash, and X2 comes here. We also do some change of variables for the vector Y such that Y1 comes here and Y2 comes here. So this ellipse is rotated just like that. And in this space, in this rotated space, for the vector X and for the vector Y, the relation between the vectors is diagonal. Here this is X1 dash, which is equal to B1. Here we have X2 dash, which is the same as B2. Here we have Y1 dash, which is equal to Z1, and here we have Y2 dash, which is equal to Z2, the second component of our vector Z right here. So we made a transformation to our vector X, and we made a different transformation to our vector Y, such that in the transformed space for both X and Y, the relation between the components is a diagonal relation, just a scaling relation, such that Z1 is equal to some scaling factor sigma 1 multiplied by b1, and z2 is equal to some other scaling factor multiplied by b2. So that's what the SVD does in the diagonalization picture. Of course, for this picture, I assume that you already know the U, sigma, and V transpose, and we will cover how to calculate those matrices in a later video, but here I am just giving you the intuition of this decomposition.